a very great campaign started by the PCRA.
It was a really tough competition between all of us.
We worked very hard for this quiz competition, and we're glad that we are selected and we are here.
We thank PCRA for giving us this opportunity to come here and hope we can get selected for the next level.
It is a very good initiative taken by PCRA to spread awareness about conservation of fuels.
हमें अपने ईंधनों को जैसे कि कोल है पेट्रोल है हमें इनको बचाना चाहिए.
We should use renewable sources such as solar energy, hydro power and thermal sources.
We are feeling a bit nervous here also.
इतना जरूरी नहीं है, जरूरी होता है एक स्पिरिट रखना और वो होती है कॉम्पिटिटिव स्पिरिट.
We will have a tough competition and we will do our best.
Hello and welcome to the fabulous fourth semi-final of India's favorite conservation quiz. PCRA presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2019. In the morning, we organized a screening round for all our lovely teams coming from Western India, collectively called Indian Vigilantes. They are here as follows. First team we had was from Dadra Nagar Haveli, Shivprakash Memorial School, Vishnu Shankar Chaube and Hardik Sharma. Then we had from Damanindiu, Holy Trinity Secondary and Higher Secondary School, Tomar Nidhish Shivpal and Patil Lokesh Vinod. Then from Goa, we had Litera Primary Zee School from Goa, Parth Boyer and Parth Heblikar. Then from Gujarat, we had Bhagwati International Public School, Suzanne Latif Bhai Mansuri and Maan Nitin Bhai Patel. Then from Maharashtra, we had Vidya Niketan English Medium School, represented by Siddharth Uttekar and Shraddhesh Tamhane. And then from Chhattisgarh, we had Nirmal Vidyalaya, represented by Aryan Singh and Devesh Chandak. And then finally, from Madhya Pradesh, we had South East Central Railway Mixed High School, represented by Sandeep Kandi and Ayush Gupta. Now, as is the protocol, we could only invite four teams on stage for the semi-final. And hold your breath, they are as follows. Starting from table A, Vidya Niketan English Medium School from Maharashtra, Siddharth and Shraddhesh. May I request you to please come up on stage and take table A. Well done. Congratulations, Team Maharashtra. Then, joining them on table B, we have from Shivprakash Memorial School, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Vishnu Shankar and Hardik. You're on table B. And now, on the other side, starting from table C, from Chhattisgarh, Nirmal Higher Secondary School, Aryan and Devesh. Congratulations. So with Maharashtra, Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Chhattisgarh on stage, they'll be joined by the team from Goa, Litera Primary Zee School, Parth and Parth. Congratulations, Team Goa. So the fight in the semi-final number four from teams from Western India will be between teams from Maharashtra, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Chhattisgarh and Goa. We'll see you in a bit. Rohini and Ishita from Jammu and Kashmir, Prithviraj and Ankit from Assam, Prashant and Sai Bharat from Karnataka. And let's find out. Hello and welcome to a fabulous fourth semi-final of PCRA Presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2019. It's a battle for your pride and honor. It's a battle for eternal glory. And Hollywood style, it's a battle to save your planet. Because that is what is common between all of us. Main hu Ajay Poonia, and here at Doordarshan Studios, New Delhi, aaj mere saath studio mein maujood hain, Western India se aaya ek strong contingent called Indian Vigilantes. They've made their journey to Delhi, but their destination is the national champion title. And now, it gives me immense pleasure to invite on stage my friend, your co-host and an ally to all these teams. Please welcome Namitaa Sachdeva. I'm sorry, one second. I'm getting... Okay. All right, so she's not here. All right, so we'll do this. All right, I'm afraid, viewers, Namitaa isn't here. So, participants, we'll have to just continue with the quiz. We'll start quickly with round number one. The rules are
as follows. Wait, I'm here. I'm sorry. I'm late. Namitaa, hello, all of you.
Namitaa, you are, of course, late.
Sorry.
Do you have something to say why you are late?
देखिए मेरे यहाँ पे टीचर मौजूद है अजय पूनिया, जो मुझसे हर वक्त ना ये पूछते रहते हैं कि तुम लेट क्यों हो गई हो, है ना, लाइक ही इज अ क्विज मास्टर यहाँ पे. लेकिन मैं आपको बता दूं कि मैं लेट क्यों हो गई. वैसे मैं देर करती नहीं हूँ, देर हो जाती है, बट देन आप लोग तो जानते ही हैं दिल्ली में जो ट्रैफिक है वो कितना ज़्यादा रहता है. अब दिल्ली के ट्रैफिक के चलते मुझे यहाँ पे पहुँचने में इसलिए लेट हुआ क्योंकि मैं फ्यूल कॉन्जर्वेशन में बहुत विश्वास करती हूँ, और ये तो तुमने ही मुझे सिखाया है ना.
Well, of course, this is what Saksham is all about.
Exactly. So, PCRA presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2019 के चलते मैंने ये सीखा है कि fuel conservation अगर आपको भी करना है, for all our home viewers and जितने भी audience आज हमारे साथ यहाँ पे मौजूद हैं, जो contestants हमारे साथ हैं, अजय और मैं भी ये सीख पाएं कि किस तरीके से हम fuel को बचा सकते हैं. तो मैंने ये किया कि जो ignition है उसे मैं ऑफ कर रही थी जब भी मैं ज़्यादा जैम में फंस रही थी या मुझे लग रहा था कि मेरा जो वेटिंग टाइम है वो ज़्यादा हो सकता है. मैंने अच्छा किया ना अजय?
I think so, and I'm sure Okay. Everybody here would agree as well.
Yeah.
I think if the audience is applauding, so perhaps we've all forgiven you for the
Thank
fact
you
that
so
you
much.
Are you are late, but please don't be late next time.
Of
this
course,
excuse won't
yes.
work every time.
Ha, exactly.
But right, so now that you're here, we can continue with the show. Would you want to share with us what PCRA is all about?
Of course, yes, I want to. In fact, PCRA ke baare mein agar baat kare, to aaj hum sab petrol conservation और रिसर्च एसोसिएशन की वजह से ही यहाँ पर मौजूद हैं आप सबके सामने, जो कि एक सोसाइटी है अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैस. साथ ही साथ लेट अस टेल यू कि सक्षम क्विज कॉन्टेस्ट 2019 इज अमंग्स द 3 नेशनल लेवल कॉन्टेस्ट ऑर्गेनाइज फॉर स्कूल स्टूडेंट्स, विच इज एसे, पेंटिंग एंड क्विज. और इन सबके पीछे सिर्फ एक ही इरादा है जो बहुत पक्का है, जो कि है फ्यूल कॉन्जर्वेशन एंड एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी.
बट एक चीज मैं फिर से एज ऑलवेज ऐड करना चाहूंगा हियर नमिता, दैट इज दैट सक्षम हियर मींस संरक्षण क्षमता महोत्सव, एंड इनकी टैगलाइन है ईंधन संरक्षण की जिम्मेदारी, जनगण की भागीदारी. नाउ नमिता, लेट मी आस्क यू अ क्वेश्चन. एज आई अनाउंस्ड, और शायद आपने मिस कर दिया होगा, बट आई एम श्योर यू कैन सी दैट दीज आर टीम्स दैट आर कॉल्ड इंडियन विजिलेंट्स. डू यू नो व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड इंडियन विजिलेंट्स?
अजय, आई वॉज एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट कि तुम आज मुझसे पूछने वाले, बिकॉज रोजाना मैं ये सवाल तुमसे पूछती हूँ. पर मुझे लगता है कि इतना कुछ सीखने के बाद इन कंटेस्टेंट से, जितने भी हमारे साथ बाकी के 3 एपिसोड्स में रहे और आज चौथे एपिसोड में हमारे साथ पूरे मजबूत इरादों के साथ हैं, जो मैं जान पाई हूँ अब तक वो ये है कि इंडियन विजिलेंस अगर इनका नाम रखा गया है तो इन्होंने खुद ने उसे अर्न किया है, जिसे अर्न करना उतना आसान नहीं था इनके लिए, क्योंकि इन्होंने बहुत सारे प्रिलिमिनरी यानी कि जो स्टार्टिंग राउंड्स थे उनको कंप्लीट किया है ऑन कंजर्वेशन, अर्थ साइंसेज, और बहुत सारी बातें इनसे पूछी गई हैं. आपको ये भी बता देते हैं कि इट वाज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द ऑनलाइन स्कूल राउंड, देन इट वेंट ऑन टू द डिस्ट्रिक्ट राउंड, उसके बाद में स्टेट राउंड, यूनियन टेरिटरी राउंड पूरा कंप्लीट करके हम लोगों को लगा कि इनका एक और टेस्ट लेना चाहिए, इसलिए इनको हमने यहां पे सीधे दिल्ली बुला लिया. और इनकी अवेयरनेस को चेक करने के लिए, इनके विजिलेंस को चेक करने के लिए ये यहां पर इस क्विज कॉन्टेस्ट में मौजूद हैं. तो सब लोग तैयार हैं हमारे साथ खेलने के लिए, राइट? सो कैन वी हैव अ ह्यूज राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर ऑल ऑफ देम.
Now is the time. Haan. Let's get familiar with our Indian vigilance, starting from Team A.
Yes, आज हमारे साथ Team A है, जो कि यहाँ पर आई है विद्या निकेतन English Medium School से. Please introduce yourself.
Hi, I am Shraddhishtha Mane, studying in class 8, Vidya Niketan English Medium School, Pune.
I am Siddharth Uttekar, studying in standard 10, Vidya Niketan English Medium School from Pune.
So the two of you are ready for the quiz?
Yeah.
पूरी तैयारी के साथ?
You've come well prepared.
Yes. Yeah,
you think your preparation is more than enough to take you through the national final?
I'm hoping.
You're hoping? And your partner, are you hoping as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's very nice. Wonderful.
That's a rather unusual way to say yeah, but good, whatever works for you. We'll move on.
Next team. Team B is with us, who have come from Shivprakash Memorial School. Kindly introduce yourself, guys.
Hi, I'm Vishnu Shankar Chaube from Shivprakash Memorial School, class 10th, Silvasa.
Hello, I'm Hardik Sharma from Shivprakash Memorial School in class 10th in Dadra Nagar Haveli.
Wow, that's amazing. Now, we are moving on to the third team, which is Team C, who have come from Nirmal Higher Secondary School, Chhattisgarh. Please introduce yourself.
Hi, myself Aryan Singh Chauhan from Nirmal Vidyalaya Jagdalpur, Chhattisgarh, studying in class 10th.
Okay.
Hi there, I'm Devesh Chandak, studying in class 10th from Nirmal Vidyalaya Jagdalpur, Chhattisgarh.
So who helped you the most in preparing yourself for the quiz?
Our teachers and parents.
Very nice. So now they have come with all the preparations. Now we are moving on to the last team, which is Team D, who have come from Litera Primary Zee School, Goa. Please introduce yourself, guys.
Hi, I'm Parth Heblekar. I'm from Litera Primary Zee School, Goa, and I study in class 10.
Okay.
My name is Parth Boyer. I study in class 10, Litera Primary Zee School, Goa.
Wow, they are very happy today, yeah. Right?
Both of them Parths. Yeah, ah. So was that the selection of the team was by accident as both Parths together?
Accident,
or yeah, because or, you know, because the name was, is nice.
The school team was selected by PCRA.
Acha, okay.
But the name is not nice.
Of course, we have the greatest name.
Greatest name.
Oh, they have the greatest name.
Let's see if you have the greatest of minds as well in today's show. Right? Yes. Welcome, Team Goa, and welcome to each one of you. Congratulations for making it thus far. Till this stage, a big bag of knowledge is what has brought you here. Mm. But now, it's all about nerves. Yeah. If you can hold your nerves when all
you
about
you. Check
you,
your nerves, first of all. Yeah. Then?
If you can keep your head. When all about you are losing theirs, I'm sure that final vacant spot in the national final will be yours. So good luck. We'll have four rounds of quizzing, one by one. We'll be going through each one of them. First, we'll start with round number one, and Namitaa will be telling you the rules. It's called Spoiled for Choice.
Now, this is the first round, which is Spoiled for Choice. Rules are here as follows. One multiple choice question would be asked from per team in this round. From team A to team D it comes from. Now, you have four options to give the answer and three attempts to answer the question. If you will be able to answer in the first attempt, you'll get plus 15, means your team will be adding with points 15. Then, if you will not be able to give the answer in the first attempt, then there is a second attempt for you available, which gives you 10 points. And then, if you are not then able to answer the question correctly, you have a third attempt to answer the question, which is plus 5. Means you'll get 5 points if you'll answer it in the third attempt. Clear? Now, there is no passing of question to the other team. Also, if you'll not give the correct answer, you'll not get any negative marking, means no deductions would be there. This is a warm-up round for you all. So, there is a chance to gain points from this round. So, be careful. Because this is the starting round, a very simple one for all of you. All of you ready?
Yes. Yeah.
Any
ready,
questions? No?
No?
So we can start with it, Ajay.
Right. First question, Team Pune, if you're ready, this is for you on your screen. Invented over 2000 years ago in China, what is this instrument the world's first? Is it A, a wind vane? Is it B, an earthquake detector? Is it C, a groundwater detector? Or is it D, a thermometer?
B, earthquake detector.
You think this is an earthquake detector?
Yeah.
That is correct. That's the
brilliant
answer.
Good
answer.
We must say.
Well done. Extremely confident as well. Right? Knew it on the first attempt. And
yes,
Namitaa will tell you
a
little more about
it. I have something to tell you about this. You might be surprised to find it out, however, that the first seismometer was a giant bronze vessel that was invented in 132 CE by a Chinese astronomer, mathematician, engineer and inventor called Zhang Heng. He was also called Shang Heng. And also, Ajay, he was an artist and a poet too.
Oh, yeah?
Right?
Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, that's great. Right, so greatness achieved by Team A, but only momentarily, because
yes,
there's a long way to go in this quiz. This is just the first question. It's a big semi-final. We'll move on to the next team in order, and that is Team Dadra Nagar Haveli. This is your question on your screen. What are these types of Bombay, Calcutta, Railway and Port Blair? A, types of blood groups. B, former time zones of India. C, names of first railway engines. Or is it D, the first Ranji teams from India?
B.
Option D, first Ranji teams of India.
They were the first Ranji teams from India. I'm afraid that is incorrect. You'll have to try again. Team B, now for 10 points.
Two more attempts left with you.
C.
Names of first railway engines. I'm afraid that is incorrect as well. Perhaps seeing Bombay, you got a bit confused.
We have asked you, what are these types of Bombay, right, Calcutta, Railway and Port Blair? Think carefully,
right,
and then
perhaps
answer.
Perhaps with
have
Bombay, you got a little
left,
confused there. The first train did run from Bombay to Thane, but that's not what this question is about. Now, please try for 5 points. You have two options, blood groups or time zones.
B
B,
former time zones of India. You know there exists a Bombay blood group as well?
No.
Okay, good that you didn't know this, because just by selection by elimination, you finally get this. You get 5 points for that one. This is indeed, these are all former time zones of India.
Yes.
And of course, now we follow Indian standard time, but Namitaa follows Indian stretchable time.
Because I was late, but I'll never be late, hai na? That's a promise to you. Now, I must tell you, this is a long explanation though. After independence, Indian Standard Time was established as the official time for the country. Even though Bombay and Calcutta retained their own time for a little or longer, the railways had their own time synchronized with Madras since it was a midway between Bombay and Calcutta. And Port Blair had its own time till 1905.
That is correct. Right, good answer. Finally, you got this one correct on the third attempt. So, you get 5 points. At least you're on the scoreboard. Please feel happy about that. Mm. Now we'll move on to the other side, Team C, Nirmal Vidyalaya, Chhattisgarh. Here's your question on your screen. In the 1860s, there was an Englishman named John Cassell marketing a kind of fuel for powering lamps, named Casoline after himself. Which fuel was thus sold with the name Casoline? Is it A, kerosene? Is it B, petroleum? Is it C, CNG? Or is it D, diesel?
A, kerosene.
I'm afraid that is incorrect. Perhaps they're similar sounding, so you might as well have thought of kerosene, but that's wrong. It's not what gasoline was.
You have two more attempts to answer the question.
And three options.
B, petroleum.
That is correct. That's the answer.
Right answer.
Good answer there, Nirmal Vidyalaya. Finally, on second attempt, you get 10 points.
And then I must tell you, the word gasoline does not come from gas. It comes from casoline oil, an early form of gasoline that was used for lighting in 19th century. John Cassell was the first to sell it commercially. What makes it confusing is that gasoline is the term used in US and Canada, while UK and India use the term petrol.
Yeah, that is correct. That confusion will remain. We don't know till how long, but no confusions here, because Team Nirmal Vidyalaya has scored 10 points. Well done. And now for the final question of this round will be for Team D, Goa. This is your question. Which of these medical discoveries occurred when an Indian military doctor treated a patient called Hussein Khan? Very interesting. A, cholera. B, Bombay blood group. C, polio. D, malaria. Which of these discoveries happened?
Is it Bombay blood group?
Because we spoke about it earlier and you took a lead from there.
Just
right?
A guess.
I'm afraid that's wrong. You'll have to try again. Try for 10 points. That's okay. Is it cholera A, is it C, polio, or is it D, malaria?
A, cholera.
That
again
is
a wrong answer.
As well. Not cholera. Is it polio or is it malaria?
C and D options for you. But then only one attempt. Only
five
one
points.
Attempt to answer the question.
Is it malaria?
It is malaria. Oh, and thank you, stars, for that. Finally, 5 points. Good answer there, Team Goa.
Yes, I must tell you, after 2 years of research failure, in 1897, Ronald Ross, the doctor in question, managed to culture 20 adult brown mosquitoes. He successfully infected the mosquitoes from a patient named Hussein Khan for a price of 8 anas. Anas, you know, na? Yes. Pehle ke time mein bahut famous hua karte the. 1 ana per blood-fed mosquito.
Right. Namitaa, for how many anas or how many rupees will you like to buy some blood-fed mosquitoes?
8 anas.
All right. Anyway, so we'll continue now. End of round one, we'll take a look at the scores and see how the teams stand after one round. So after round one, it's Team A from Maharashtra. They're currently leading with a score of 15 points. Closely following them is Team C from Chhattisgarh. You're on 10 points. And sharing the scores at 5 points each is Team D from Goa. You're on 5. And also Team B from Dadra Nagar Haveli. You're on 5 points as well.
We can say it's a good start.
Yeah, I think it's a very nice start. The scoreboard tells us that Team A is enjoying themselves, but fortunes though can change immediately, as we saw in the last episode.
Yes, exactly.
Where a team came from behind just before the finish line and won the quiz and qualified and made their way through into the final. We'll see if history will repeat itself. Lots of questions to be answered, lots of points to be won, and lots of fun to be had. But all of that after this short break. When we return, we'll see what these teams have to say about conservation. Stay with us.
Petroleum padarth seemit hain aur jald hi khatam ho jane wale hain. Isiliye in durlabh padarth ko bachana zaruri hai. LPG bachane ke liye pressure cooker ka istemal karein. PCRA dwara bataye gaye sadharan tips apnaiye. आइए दोस्तों हम ईंधन बचाएं और देश की प्रगति में हाथ बटाएं।
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और LPG बचत के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
मंजिल उन्हीं को मिलती है जिनके सपनों में जान होती है। पंखों से कुछ नहीं होता, हौसलों से उड़ान होती है। जी हाँ, अगर हौसले मजबूत हों और इरादे पक्के हों तो फिर जीत आपकी होगी और आपको मंजिल जरूर मिलेगी। और उन्हीं पक्के इरादों के साथ आज हमारे साथ यहाँ पर चार चार टीम्स मौजूद हैं, इंडियन विजिलेंस, जिनके लिए एक बार जोरदार तालियां मैं यहाँ पे बजाना चाहती हूँ और ये कहना भी चाहती हूँ कि इनके हौसले कितने मजबूत हैं और ये लोग फ्यूल कॉन्जर्वेशन के लिए क्या कुछ करते हैं। अभी अभी इन यंग माइंड्स को आपने सुन ही लिया। वेल, मुझे लगता है कि अभी राउंड नंबर 2 की शुरुआत करनी चाहिए।
एब्सोल्युटली, लेट्स स्टार्ट।
So round number 2 is infinite bounce round for you all. I must tell you the rules of this round. This round consists of 8 questions. 8 questions means 2 questions each team we are going to ask you. Passing on from team A to team D and then from team D to team A. If the direct team answers it correctly, they will get 10 points. If not, then the question will be automatically gets transferred or passed on to the other team we have. If they answer it correctly, then it's fine. If not, then the passing goes on and on. This is a no buzzer round. And first of all, happy faces dekhne ke liye main bata deti hu, there'll be no deduction of points. Yeah. So you don't have to worry on that. But then you have to be very alert because do questions ek team se puche jayenge and this is a chance to gain more points for you, right?
Yes, because there won't be any negatives. So please keep on collecting as many points as you can. They will really help your cause towards the later part of this quiz.
Yes.
If you're ready, we'll start. Team A, Pune, here's your question on your screen. Visits to which location are thus provided by Lonely Planet at as low as $63? You can see a visual on screen as well. Which location am I talking of?
Bhopal.
That is correct. That's Bhopal.
Brilliant it is.
This is the site of Bhopal gas tragedy. You can see a Union Carbide logo as well, and that is what it is all about. You can perhaps call it disaster tourism. Good answer. Team Pune opening the account in this round. You were leading. You still have a few more points that you've earned. So you get 10 points on this one. We'll now move on to the next team in question. That's Team B. Here's your question on your screen. It's a video. Watch the video.
All right, so here we are, one of the elephants. Cool thing about these guys is that they have really, really, really long trunks. And that's cool. And that's pretty much all there is to say.
Right, you saw the video. That was Javed Karim. The question is, what is the significance of this YouTube video uploaded in April 2005? It has over 60 million views. As you can see, it's nothing fancy. You don't even see a cat in the image. You only see an elephant. Why does it still have 60 million views? What is so significant?
Endangered species.
Endangered species, which is man or elephant?
Elephant.
Elephant, okay. That is incorrect. We'll pass now to Team C. What is the significance of this video, Chhattisgarh? No answers coming. We'll move on to
the other
team
was doing
Goa,
like,
smiling and waiting.
We know that.
The man gets killed by the elephants after this.
Not the right answer.
It's not a fatal question at all. Nobody died while making this video. Anyway, we'll move on to Team A.
This video was the first video on YouTube.
That wow! Amazing!
That's the answer. Good answer there by Team Pune. Starring Javed Karim, who's one of the co-founders of YouTube.
Yep.
Right? And that's what it was about. It was just a very nondescript video of him at a zoo. The video is also titled Me at the Zoo. Nobody died, Team Goa. Nobody died. Good answer.
And so far, Team A knows all the answers.
Consistently building on their lead. Yep. That's another 10 points to you. Well done. We'll now move on to the third question, and this will be for Team C. Alkaloid theobromine is sometimes used as a drug to treat high blood pressure. Its effects are similar to caffeine and can be poisonous to dogs, as they metabolize it very slowly, thus making it toxic. What commonly enjoyed food contains theobromine and thus should not be given to dogs? Namitaa, you have pets at home?
Yeah.
You do? Okay, yeah. Whatever the answer is, don't feed it to your dog. Okay, Team C.
That's a tip, basically. And the answer is so simple.
What commonly enjoyed food? Namitaa, do you enjoy it as well?
Yeah, yeah. Of course. Girls usually enjoy it. Na?
Okay.
I don't know about you.
I do, time and again. Not always.
I think it's cold drinks.
Cold drinks, no.
That is right. Don't give cold drinks to your dogs.
Yes,
but
exactly.
Not the answer that I'm looking
answer
for.
Answer is not correct.
Yeah. We'll move on to Team D, Goa.
It's chocolate.
Is correct.
Wow.
That's the answer. Good answer there. Well done, Team Goa. You get 10 points. And we'll now move on to the next question. This is number 4 and that will be for Team Goa as well. Flagged off in January 2015, this is a passenger train running between Rohtak and Rewari in North India, in Haryana. What is special about this Indian Railways train?
Consume biofuel.
Okay, you have any specific fuel in mind?
Ethanol.
Okay, incorrect. Not ethanol, not specifically running on any biofuel. I'll pass now to Team A. Pune?
Is it a medical train?
It's not a medical train. Passes now to Team B. It's a Lifeline Express, that's something else. Team B?
It's the first sanitary train.
First sanitary train. Okay, that is incorrect as well. Team C, Nirmal Vidyale?
It runs on biogas.
Is not incorrect exactly. As well. The right answer, anybody in the audience would like to try? Okay. The right answer is it was the first CNG train. That was the answer that I was looking for.
And this the was answer was simple.
The first CNG train, right? Perhaps the color scheme was a good bit of hint, but nobody took that one.
Yes, exactly.
So that's the end of 4 questions, first part of this round. We will continue in reverse order, starting with Team D. Team Goa, here's your question. We'll reverse the order. We'll go DCBA. This is your question on your screen. Sonam Wangchuk, Ryan Life Fungsuk Wangru of Three Idiots, create such structures to freeze and hold the water that keeps flowing and is wasted. In summers, the ice will melt and provide water for fields. What are these artificial glaciers called? They're called ice slanks.
Stupas.
Stupas, absolutely. Wow. That's the answer. Good answer.
Impressive answer. Wow.
Yeah, very impressive.
And they knew it.
Good answer. 10 points, Team Goa. Next question will be for Team Chhattisgarh. This is your question on your screen. In Africa, the elephants have started adapting to their threats, that is, poaching, and now born without a particular feature for which they were poached. 98% of elephants in South Africa are born without it. What physical feature are they letting go due to poaching pressure? So now elephants are adapting to something. As much as 98% in South Africa are being born without it. What am I talking about?
Is that tusk?
It is indeed tusk.
Tusk is the right
That's the answer.
Answer.
Good answer. Well done, Team Chhattisgarh. That's a plus 10 to you. Very good. Tusk. So that's how bad the poaching has been, that elephants are now adapting to being taking birth without tusks. Good answer, Team C, Chhattisgarh. That gets you 10 points. Now we'll move across to Team B. Here's your question on your screen. What recent development in the Middle East is this The Economist magazine cover all about? What is this about?
There is a hint in the picture.
Now, take a good look at the visual and perhaps you can get your answer from there.
Yep.
Yes, Team B?
It allows the voting rights to the women in Saudi Arabia.
Is incorrect. That's not what it talks about. We'll move on to Team A from Pune.
It has made driving for women legal.
Correct. Women can now drive in Saudi Arabia. That is what this magazine cover illustrates. If you take a good look at it carefully, you'll see the eyes are in the form of a car tire. Very well identified there by Team A, Pune. You get 10 points. And now for the final question of this round, we'll move on to Team Pune again. Here's your question. It is a way of turning carbon emissions into a tradable commodity. In recent years, the idea of issuing a certain number of these to large polluters and then allowing them to trade them is seen as a viable way to lower greenhouse gas emissions. What am I talking about?
Are these some kind of tokens?
Some kinds of tokens. That is incorrect. Not any kinds of tokens. For a very specific term.
Say it. Carbon tax.
Carbon tax. That is incorrect. Passes to Nirmal Vidyale. Team C.
CNG.
CNG.
Yes.
Okay, done with CNG for the day. Right? Enough CNG for the day. Passes now to Team B. No.
Carbon filter.
I'm afraid everybody missed out. The right answer is carbon credits, not carbon tax, not carbon filter, but carbon credits. Hard luck, no points to anyone. And that brings us to the end of round number two. We'll take a look at the scoreboard. Scoreboard tells us that Team A from Maharashtra, continuing on with their lead, in fact, building on their lead, they're now leading with a score of 45 points. Some distance away is Team B from Goa. They're on 25 points. And then we have Team C from Chhattisgarh on 20 points. And finally, Team B on 5 points. So those are the scores after the end of two rounds.
And as we always say, ki kismat ka sikka kabhi bhi palat sakta hai. Aur hume yahan par aaj luckiest nahi balki smartest teams chahiye, jo ki hum dekh pa rahe ki round 2 ke baad jo scores hain wo kis tarah se badle hain. But filhal yahan par, this is the time to take a short commercial break. We'll be back in no time, so don't go anywhere. Stay with us in PCRA Presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2019.
Yellow.
Good news, sir. आज से आपको पेट्रोल पे 20% का डिस्काउंट मिलेगा.
20%. 20%.
लॉटरी लग गई. तो मेरे बाकी के पैसे लूटे डाले.
वो तो आपके हाथ में ना. 45 की स्पीड पे गाड़ी चलाइए. रेड लाइट पे इंजन ऑफ कर दीजिए. 20% पेट्रोल तो जरूर बचेगा. बात तो वही है ना.
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें. पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी.
Welcome back to PCRA Presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2019, semi-final 4. As someone said, the earth doesn't belong to us, we belong to the earth. Similarly, a spot in the national final doesn't belong to you, you have to fight for it.
Exactly.
As winners of your online school rounds, district rounds and state rounds, perhaps winning is a habit. But today, for three of our Indian vigilants, that habit will be broken because only one team will make their way through into the final. Halfway into the quiz, it's Team A from Maharashtra that's looking good with a score of 45 points. But the other three teams will wake up and smell the coffee. It's round three. It's called Take Your Pick.
So now, Take Your Pick is a very interesting round, we must tell you. Now, 8 topics will be displayed on your TV screens in this round. We will start the round in the ascending orders of the scores. Since Team B is on the lowest marking points, so we'll start from them because they have got 5 points, so they have the chance to gain marks from this. Now, I must tell you, ki points are written in front of the topics. Some questions are for 15 pointers, some are for the 10 pointers, and the others are very simple questions for 5 pointers. You have to select one topic of your choice. If the direct team answers it correctly, they'll get plus 15, 10 or 5, whatever they have chosen for. If not, there is a twist in the story. And what's the twist? He is going to tell.
Parampara ke mutabik, twist toh hamesha hone wala hai. Aur is baar bhi twist ye hai that there are buzzers in this round. Hit the buzzers if you think the direct team is not giving a right answer or if you think that you have the right answer. If you're right, you'll get 5, 10 or 15, whatever was chosen. If not, minus 5. Right, so there is a negative if you don't give me a right answer on the buzzer. Okay, so first we'll take a look at the topics. The topics are on your screen. Now we're ready. I hope team Dadra and Nagar Haveli is ready as well. So 15 pointer questions will be asked by Namitaa. But if you want 5 or 10, I'll be asking them.
Natural phenomena.
You want natural phenomena? This is for 10 points. On your screen, other teams, you run the buzzer for plus 10 and minus 5. Natural phenomena. Raindrops are perfectly spherical. Because of this, it has a very measured refraction index. If a source of light was behind you and you stood at a 42 degree angle from your shadow and the aforementioned refraction took place in front of you, what would you see? Team D has shown interest, but they will wait. Wait till Dadra
and Nagar. Spectrum of light.
You will see a spectrum of light. Rainbow. And what do you think that spectrum of light is?
Rainbow.
Is a rainbow. Absolutely. Wow. That's the answer. Good answer there. Team Dadra and Nagar Haveli, a very valuable 10 points because you are trailing all the other teams and these are 10 points that will really help your cause. Good answer. 10 points. Well done. This is a rainbow. Good. Next question will be now for Team C. Nirmal Vidyalaya, what do you want?
Atmosphere.
Atmosphere, here's your question on your screen. Meaning heat sphere, what is the outer layer of the atmosphere? It begins at 80 kilometers above the Earth's surface, has the International Space Station orbiting in it as well.
Is it thermosphere?
It is indeed thermosphere. Maharashtra had hit the buzzer, but they can't answer because Nirmal Vidyalaya has got this one correct. That is the answer that we were looking for. Absolutely, thermosphere. 10 points. Well done. Now we'll move on. Move on to Goa from Chhattisgarh.
Which topic do you want?
Unique feet.
Unique feet. So that's for 15 points. Namitaa,
so
go for it.
My turn to question. Your question is on your TV screen, which is Tsutomu Yamaguchi, nicknamed Lucky, died in 2010 at the age of 93 from stomach cancer. He was given the nickname for being the only person to survive what?
Hiroshima and Nagasaki bombings.
Oh, wow. That's really amazing. I knew the answer.
Yeah. I knew the answer. He survived both. Yes. So you can call him unlucky for a very brief period of 3 days. Because from Hiroshima, he went to Nagasaki and Nagasaki, the bomb was dropped again. So he survived that too.
So and that's why he was called Lucky.
And eventually died in 2010, and thus the nickname Lucky. Well done, wow. Good answer. Not just lucky, but very smart there. Team Goa, that gets you 15 points. Well done.
Amazing.
Now for the leaders before this round to Maharashtra. Team A, what do you want?
Statue.
You'll take statue.
Okay.
Statue is a question for 10 points. On your screen, here it comes. This park was completed in 2018 and is located in Chadayamangalam in Kerala. Who is this park dedicated to and why such a specific location?
That is Jatayu.
Okay, and why such a specific location?
It is on the way, it is in between Lanka and India.
It is situated midway between Lanka and
India.
India. I will still give that to you. It is indeed Jatayu. The reason was not because it is midway between Lanka and India, but actually because after the fight with Ravan, this is where it fell. And that is what this sculpture also depicts. So I'll give that to you. Good answer there. That gets you 10 points. Well done. Okay, so we're done with first part of this quiz, of this round. Now we'll continue to the second part. Four more questions remain. We'll start with Team B, Dadra Nagar Haveli. What do you want?
Like crucial. Assam history.
Okay. Much deliberation. Here's your question on your screen.
Located in Tezpur, this is the grave of Charles Alexander Bruce, the discoverer of Dash in Assam, more than 170 years ago. Fill in the blank.
Okay, Team A, Pune has hit the buzzer, but they will wait. First, we'll wait for Dadra and Nagar Haveli to give us an answer.
Tea plantation.
That's the answer. Good answer there, Team Dadra and Nagar Haveli. Good answer. 15 points.
And now tea is really famous in India. Yeah. Everyone likes that.
Last episode, we asked a question on coffee.
Coffee, of course.
So we've done justice to tea. Perhaps next time we should ask a question on sugar cane. Right. Next question will now be for Team C.
Indian President.
President for 5 points.
Yeah.
Here's your question on your screen. Identify the former Indian president whose statue has been placed in a temple in Tamil Nadu. And we've identified that. But of course, his image, his statue has been pixelated. Right, who was this Indian president who was placed there in a temple in Tamil Nadu? There's nobody on the buzzer as well. So your answer, no negative, 5 points if you're right, Chhattisgarh, is?
So teams can still press the buzzer if they know the answer.
APJ Abdul Kalam.
Is correct, APJ that's
Abdul
the answer.
Kalam. Wow.
APJ Abdul Kalam. Coming from that part of the country, good answer there, Team C. Took you some time, but as long as you give me a right answer, 5 points. Well done. Right. Next question will now be for Team D from Goa. Which of the two 5-pointers do you want?
Nursery rhyme.
Nursery rhyme? Okay. Here's your question on nursery rhymes for 5 points. Other teams? Plus five, minus five. In medieval times in Europe, 1/3 of the taxes went to the king, 1/3 went to the nobility, and 1/3 went to common man. What poem is explained here? And before you answer, how long has it been since you went to nursery class?
Okay.
A decade.
More than a decade.
All right. Nevertheless, let's have your answer.
Is it Baba Black Sheep?
Baba Black Sheep. Why would you say Baba Black Sheep?
Because it goes Baba like one sack for the whatever. I don't remember the poem.
I don't remember.
Yeah, because it's been more than a decade.
Yeah, but there are three sacks I remember, and one goes to the poor boy. So.
Is correct. That's the answer.
Mama,
we have explained it well.
Yeah, explaining it completely. Well done. 5 points on identifying nursery rhymes very well. Doesn't pass to team Maharashtra, who showed interest on that one. But what we can do for Maharashtra is give you a direct question. Maharashtra, your question will be from Hot Springs, because that's the only one left, for 5 points on your screen. Deriving its name from an Icelandic word meaning erupt, what term is given to a natural hot spring that intermittently ejects a column of water and steam into the air?
Geyser.
Geyser, absolutely. Right. Good answer there. That's a plus 5. Well done. So that brings us to the end of the third round as well. Here's a look at the scores. Scores as follows. After 3 rounds, we have Team A from Maharashtra still leading with a score of 60 points. And Team B from Goa is slowly and slowly inching closer with a score of 45 points. They're followed by Team C from Nirmal Vidyalaya from Chhattisgarh on 35. And Team B from Dadra Nagar Haveli back into reckoning with a score of 30 points. He's 5 points behind. So this is how the scoreboard shapes up after 3 rounds. We're headed into our final round. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
मैंने सोच लिया है जब मैं बड़ा हो जाऊंगा ना तब मैं साइकिल रिपेयर की दुकान खोलूंगा
क्यों
जिस तरह आप सब पेट्रोल वेस्ट कर रहे हैं फ्यूचर में तो पेट्रोल बचेगा ही नहीं तब तो सब साइकिल ही चलाएंगे ना
खुद ही सारा पेट्रोल खत्म करेंगे या कुछ अपने बच्चों के लिए भी छोड़ेंगे प्लीज कम से कम सिग्नल पे तो इंजन ऑफ कीजिए
पीसीआरए का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी
Let's move on to round number 4. It's called Clutopia.
So let's start with the rules of this round, which is Clutopia round. This is purely a buzzer round, I must tell you. इसमें हम direct teams के पास नहीं आ रहे हैं सवाल करने के लिए. जैसे ही आपको a question सामने आता है TV screen पर, you just have to hit the buzzer if you know the answer. You have 3 clues to answer the question. First clue is the question itself. If you know the answer, hit the buzzer, you'll get 15 points. If not, means if you not give the correct answer at the first clue, you'll get second chance to answer the question, which is the vowels, or we can say the next clue will be shown to you on your screen for 10 points. If you answer it correctly, in the second clue, you'll get 10 points. And if not, there is a third clue for you in which you can answer it rightly. If you answer it in the third clue, which is the anagrams, means the jumbled letters, you have to arrange it carefully, then you will be adding 5 points to your points table. All the rules clear?
Namitaa,
yes.
I don't think you have given them complete rules because kahani ka twist aap fir bhool gaye. The kahani ka twist is on the buzzer, minus 5 if you're wrong.
Yes.
First clue minus 5 if you're wrong, second clue minus 5 if you're wrong, third clue minus 5 if you're wrong.
So only hit the buzzer if you know the answer, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Hmm. When you're certain, hit the buzzer. Here's first question, first clue on your screen for 15 points.
Photo mein aisi baat. में ऐसी बात में दबा के चली आई खुल जाए वही बात तो दुहाई है दुहाई
ओके राइट सो यू सॉ वीडियो And Team C has hit the buzzer. The question is to showcase the culture and colors of this country. The director of Jewel Thief from 1967 decided to shoot this song in which landlocked country? Chhattisgarh for 15 points if you're right.
China.
I'm afraid the question said landlocked country. China is not a landlocked country. It wasn't filmed in China. So that's a minus 5 Team C. We'll move on to clue number 2. 1967, the film. Which landlocked country?
Now the hint is in front of you. The vowels. You just have to complete it. Fill in the blank.
6 letter name of a country. 1960s. No one's trying for 10 points. We'll move on to clue number 3.
Okay. Team
it
B.
Is Team B from Dadra and Nagar Haveli. Your answer is? You have to give an answer right now. 3 seconds. 2. 1. Why did you hit the buzzer if you had no idea? That's a minus 5. They did not even give an answer. That brings us to the end of question 1. The film was in 1960s. During that time, before it became a state of India, Sikkim was an independent country.
Yes.
You just had to unjumble these letters and
it was
perhaps
so simple
thought,
to arrange that.
You thought Sikkim, I am certain of that, but you thought that that was a state and not a country. In 1960s, it was a different country altogether. Hmm. Question number 2 on your screen. Extending to a depth of 2900 kilometers, making it the thickest layer of the earth, it is divided into an upper and lower part separated by the transition zone. What part of the earth's structure is this? 15 points, Team Pune. In an attempt to extending their lead, Team A.
The core.
The core, I'm afraid that is incorrect. It's a minus 5. Other teams heaving a sigh of relief. Let's move on to clue number 2. This team is B. Team B, Dadra Nagar Haveli.
Mental.
Your answer?
Mental.
Is a mental.
That's nice.
Answer. Good answer.
They have picked it up nicely.
This time you worked it out. This time you get a 10 pointer. Well done. Good answer. This is not the core, but the mantle. That's the thickest layer of the earth's surface. Well done, Team B. Plus 10. Next question, number 3 on your screen. This is the Water Cup, created by Kiran Rao's Pani Foundation. This is awarded every year to community with best solutions for water conservation. What two words from the Mundak Upanishad is the cup title? What two words from the Mundak Upanishad? No one's trying.
So we can move on to clue 2.
Clue number 2. Two words.
Which are the two words?
From the Mundak Upanishad. Very familiar two words. Team D, Goa, taking the bait. Your answer.
Is it Satyamev Jayate?
Yes, it is indeed
exactly,
Satyamev Jayate. Absolutely. Good answer. Team Goa, plus 10. Well done. We had Kiran Rao's husband, Amir Khan, in a show, Satyamev Jayate. Last year in 2018, we had a film, Satyamev Jayate, which is what this cup is also titled. Well done. Well identified there. Team Goa, two questions remain. Here's number 4. In April 2017, the army recruitment drive saw alarming results. 1 out of 3 people from Kanpur had succumbed to gutka addiction, thus leading to which disease? Team A has hit the buzzer.
Cancer.
Cancer. You want to elaborate on that?
Gutka causes cancer of throat.
I think let's not be so harsh on them. It is oral cancer. Or mouth cancer. Good answer. That's the answer that I was looking for. Good answer.
In Maharashtra,
15 points and you've turned the quiz back in your favor. Right, so the army recruitment drive found that 1 out of 3 applicants were suffering from oral cancer. That's how bad that it was. Now, for the final question of not just this semi-final, but across all semi-finals on your screen now. The FAME India scheme is aimed at incentivizing all vehicle segments, that is two-wheelers, three-wheelers, auto, passenger four-wheeler vehicle, light commercial vehicles and buses. What does E stand for in FAME? There's a visual as well. FAME India, National Mission on
what?
Team B, Dadra Nagar Haveli.
Electricity.
Electricity.
That's fine.
It's a far bit closer to the answer.
That's fine. National Mission on electric mobility. I will give that to you for electricity. Fair enough. 15 points. Well done. Good answer. Really making this round work in your favor is Team Dadra Nagar Haveli. Gets a 15 pointer on this one. And that brings us to the end of an exciting semi-final round here. Let's take a final look at the scoreboard. Ending with a score of 30 points, we have Team C from Nirmal Vidyalaya, Chhattisgarh. And then with lots of buzzer-heavy action, but wasn't enough, too little, too late, we have Team B finishing with a score of 50 points from Dadra and Nagar Haveli. Team D momentarily was in a joint lead, just like a budget airline and a small airport, quick touchdown and return. They finish with a score of 55 points. And our winners and our qualifiers into the national final is the team from Maharashtra with a score of 70 points. Head to head went the fight to the finish in semi-final 4 of PCRA Presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2019. A thriller for our viewers, a chiller for us. And in Siddharth and Shradesh from Vidya Niketan English Medium School from Pune, a winner from Maharashtra.
वेल यहां से आज हमारे साथ ग्रैंड फिनाले में जाने वाले हैं, एंट्री लेने वाले हैं महाराष्ट्र की टीम विद्या निकेतन इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल, द टू सिद्धार्थ एंड श्रद्धेश विद वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग नेम्स. And for now, we would like to invite our chief guest here on the stage to please give away the prizes, who is the Director Education Campaign from PCRA, Mr. Tarachand.
So, can you have you on stage?
Nice to have you here.
Now, we would like to invite our winning team from Vidya Niketan English Medium School, Maharashtra, Siddharth and Shradesh, to please come up here and take away the award from Tarachand, sir.
So that confirms their participation in the national finals. Zonal finalists from Indian Vigilantes, the team from Pune, the team from Maharashtra. देखा आपने how when it mattered the most team Maharashtra pushed the pedal to the metal and secured a spot in the national final. लहरों से डरकर नौका पार नहीं होती,
कोशिश करने वालों की हार नहीं होती.
So that means in the next episode in the national final from Jammu Kashmir in the north to Assam in the east to Karnataka in the south and now to Maharashtra in the west, the whole of India will be playing. And we hope the whole of India will be watching.
Yeah, that's right. And that's a wrap from all of us here from Doordarshan Studios. This is Namitaa Sachdeva.
And this is Ajay Poonia.
Leaving you with a promise that we'll be back on the biggest day of PCRA Presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2019. It's the national finale.
History will be rewritten. Goodbye.